It's Halloween week, and we want to know if you've had any ghost experiences.
I do believe in ghosts.
Absolutely. 100% believe in ghosts.
I don't actually believe in ghosts, but I have worked in a castle where an episode of Most Haunted was filmed, and I spent a long time trying to find some ghosts myself, but sadly to no avail.
Absolutely.
No.
No.
I think there are definitely places where I've been that have like ghost stories associated with them, and like not being in the place, I don't believe it, but then like once I get there, I'm kind of like, okay.
My house is haunted back home. It's so weird. One day I went into my bedroom and I was just sitting on my bed and the light started shaking. The wardrobe started shaking before. So yeah, definitely.
I don't believe in ghosts, no.
She doesn't know a thing, honestly.
Ghost. Do you believe in like haunted houses? Would you go to a haunted house? Would you stay?
I would never go, but because I believe, so I wouldn't go.
I've met up with Richard, the local ghost tour leader.
I think it all started in 1987, so sort of over four decades ago, if you like. Started doing research on the paranormal in St Andrews, and put a letter in the Reader's Digest, Scots Magazine, all the local papers at that time. There was no internet, so it was all by longhand, and it resulted a couple of weeks later in receiving so much information through the mail from all over the world, people's experiences and accounts. And it all culminated in publishing two books in November last year, and then started doing the tours on the back of the books this year, so started around about June.
Have you always been interested in ghosts since you were younger?
Yeah, it was. I think I was about 6 years old when I saw my first ghost, if you like, first apparition. It was a woman that used to stand at the bottom of my bed, and I was never scared. I always thought she was there to protect me, if you like, so it wasn't something that that I was kind of worried about. And I never tried to communicate with her or anything, but it wasn't until a number of years later that I actually mentioned it to my parents. And when I started seeing the ghost, it coincided with when an old lady died through the wall in the next room, if you like, in the next house. But being that kind of age, my parents, they didn't really want to talk about death, so it wasn't for quite a while later. But when I did speak about it, they realized it was the woman that died next door. That was the person that I saw.
Where are we right now? Like, what is the significance?
Well, this is the Haunted Tower. It features the apparition of the White Lady. It's the most prolific ghost in St Andrews. She hit the national press around about 1894 with speculation from professors and academics trying to figure out who it was that was haunting this area. And she's done so for nearly two centuries now. So the apparition of a White Lady.
Still see ghosts on a regular basis?
Apart from the living ones, usually I don't, but some extraordinary things have happened on the tours, especially at the Haunted Tower just here. People have tried to take photos inside the chamber there, and something's completely shut down their camera phone or shut down the digital camera. There was some people as well. I mean, one of the old legends of the tower here is if you put your arm in there, you can shake hands with the White Lady. Who used to be entombed within there. And sometimes people that have been on the tours, they've put their arm through there. They're laughing and joking to start with, and then they stop laughing when something kind of starts grabbing their arm, and it's as though something's pulling their arm. So it's quite interesting.
I don't feel anything. And how would other people be able to join your tour?
Essentially by booking through the website, through Visit Scotland, or turning up at Church Square. At one of the different times during the day. So it's 7 days a week that I run the tours. So 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 7 and 9 o'clock. So plenty of options for people there.
If there's something strange in your neighbourhood, who are you going to call?
Ghost.
My wardens.
Oh, it's really hard questions.
If there's something strange in your neighbourhood, who are you going to call?
My mom.
I'm going to call myself.
I'd say this afternoon was pretty scary.
The final question.
Miriam.
Ghostbusters, obviously. Come on. I ain't afraid of no ghost.